Love doing a master's in applied physics, and I also joined the Google Summer of Code 2021. In my case, the project was named Qt TensorFlow, and before diving into what Qt TensorFlow is in this presentation, let me give you a brief update on where Qt 5 stands. So currently, Qt is in version 4, and it includes, and there is a new version for Qt, Qt 5, that is under active development. And the nice feature of this new version of Qt is that it includes a new dispatching system that allows the use of multiple backends. So example of those backends are the dense matrices that are very similar to NumPy's array that is natively implemented in Qt 5, and also the CSR matrices that are similar to SciPy's CSR array. And another example is the Philips example, which is the QPy backend. And Qt TensorFlow is yet another backend for Qt that has a similar scope. So Qt 5, Qt TensorFlow is a plugin for Qt 5 that includes the TensorFlow linear algebra backend. This means that you are allowed to, with Qt TensorFlow, you can operate also with a GPU. And quite interestingly, you are also able to benefit from some of TensorFlow's implementation, some of TensorFlow's functions, such as, for example, auto-differentiation and some minimization algorithms that are already implemented in TensorFlow. For Qt TensorFlow, we also include a small set of benchmarks that can help you to assess whether you benefit, for instance, from this potential speed-up that you can get from GPUs. Now, going to these benchmarks, when I started this project, I started benchmarking how Qt dense the native backend that we have in Qt compares to the TensorFlow backend. And it turns out that if you are using complex 128 numbers and the GPU that you use is the one I have available, this GTX 970, it turns out that Qt dense performs better than Qt TensorFlow. So operating a GPU is worse for this particular case that operating with a CPU. Now, this is what you can see here. This is quite interesting. Here is the matrix multiplication. I plot this matrix multiplication, the time it takes for these matrix multiplications versus the size of the matrices that are being employed. And you can see that Qt dense, which is the one that works in the CPU, doesn't perform Qt diff tensor. The reason for that, this particular case to happen, so the reason for this not to be the case is that the GPU I'm using is most efficient when you are doing a floating point 32 arithmetic, or in the fact you are doing a complex 64 arithmetic. And it turns out that if you switch the data type to be complex 64, you have a considerable loss of accuracy that has to be taken into account. But the nice thing is that you get huge improvement in performance, which is what you see here. Now this time, yes, you see the honest line that relates to the GPU crossing with the blue line that is related to the CPU, and at this region here for large matrices, working with a GPU, so some interesting speed up. Now at this moment, let me say that complex 64 is not supported in Qt TensorFlow, but I hope to include this support in the near future. So the takeaway here is that if you are using if you want to use this software to improve your performance in your code, you might want to run these benchmarks first to see if there is really any improvement to be obtained from using Qt TensorFlow. And in general, if you are trying to use a consumer hardware such as the one I'm using, you will be better using complex 64 than complex 128. Now, this is not the only feature that Qt TensorFlow brings. The other one is that you can benefit for some of TensorFlow's native functionality. And in particular, the one we've been testing is the ability to support auto-differentiation. So at this moment, auto-differentiation is supported with Qt TensorFlow. And you can also use some of the minimization algorithms that are implemented in TensorFlow, such as Adams, HGD, etc. So this allows you to work with Qt and still benefit from some of the TensorFlow features. Now, if you're interested in this particular application, I recommend you to take a look at the examples in Qt TensorFlow, as there is a very nice example where you can see Yeah, the potential use case of this auto-differentiation and minimization features. So to summarize, Qt TensorFlow is a nice example of how to extend the Qtip backends. It allows operating with a GPU, and it has some interesting features such as auto-differentiation and minimization that you can benefit from. Now I would like to thank my mentors, that's been Eric, Jake, Sanawas, and Simon, and also the whole Qtip admin team. And thank you all of you for your attention. And if you have any question, please go ahead.